I wouldn't want to have to try to play his horn after he had played it. I guess it probably kept the horn cleaned out. Anyway, he taught me how to play the trombone. Actually, he didn't. He taught me the seven steps on a trombone, the seven positions on the slide, and taught me this B-flat scale. And then he started teaching me the trombone parts to some of the famous marches. And lo and behold, for the first summer when I was 11 years old, I was in the city band, marching along with you. Most of them were older, and it was during the Depression, and several of them were out of work. And the dollar or so that they got for playing on the Saturday night band came in mighty handy. I learned to play the trombone parts to most of the famous marches. I couldn't really read music. I had a good ear, and when he was playing the trumpet along beside me, I learned how to play the trombone parts, but I didn't learn to read very well. And days like the 4th of July were marching time. Every town used to have a little parade on the holidays, and all the bands and everything got out on the 4th of July and played the good old marches. And I thought we ought to start the program with a good old march, one of Sousa's most famous and most popular, Bob Crosby's Bobcats. And this is the Stars and Stripes Forever. Didn't play it like that, of course, but it brought back a lot of memories. You couldn't march at that tempo. You had to slow things down for a march tempo. But that record is worth the price of admission just for the last chorus that Yank Lawson played. It's a wonder everybody didn't stop and turn around and look to see where all that sound was coming from. Anyway, that brings back some memories of the way the 4th of July used to be. And even if we are weak leg, let's see, we have some Basieites here. As a matter of fact, the title of the album is Like Basie, Paul Quinichet and his Basieites, along with Al Gray's trombone, Sweets Edison and Snooky Young, and Dick Vance and Shad Collins, a full trumpet section. Joe Jones, the drummer, Eddie Jones, the bassist, Freddie Green, guitar, and Nat Pierce with his Basie-like piano. And remembering Basie's arrangement so well of Jump the Blues Away.
Every day I have the blues, every day.
Who says Sarah can't sing the blues? That was Every Day I Have the Blues, Joe Williams' big hit originally with the Basie Band. Sarah singing it with the Thad Jones Mel Lewis Orchestra providing the background. Here's the original Red Norvo trio. There were several different versions of this trio that made records, and they were all good. But this is the one with Charlie Mingus bass and Red Norvo at the vibes. And that's only two. Who's the third one? Oh, Tal Farlow, guitar. And one of their earliest records, this originally was on the Discovery label, Little White Lies. Trio with Tal Farlow guitar and Charlie Mingus bass and Red at the vibes. Little White Lies. Let's take another march around the dinner table. Work off some of that excess. You know what? And that was The Thunderer. One of those good old Sousa marches. Makes you want to get up and even march at that tempo. That was almost the tempo that the college bands used to have when they go into their formations. When you play the trombone out there on the football field, bouncing around on the lip, very, very hard on the embouchure. Speaking of embouchures, Yank Lawson again featured with the trumpet leading them through that one. Let's listen to Clark Terry. This is a thing that was made in Copenhagen with some visiting American musicians, including Clark and his trumpet and flugelhorn and vocal. Kenny Drew was the pianist. He chose to live in Copenhagen. Red Mitchell was visiting, the bassist, and Ed Thigpen, the drummer. He, too, chose to live in Europe. This is the Bayside Cookout. Joe Sullivan at the piano playing Summertime. Here's Horace Silver in that all-star group of his that included Blue Mitchell. This was probably the least known of the Horace Silver quintets, and I think one of the best. These were the sides that introduced me to Blue Mitchell, who I think is one of the most underrated young trumpet players. Was. He died at an early age. And Junior Cook was tenor saxophone. Gene Taylor bass, and Roy Brooks the drummer, and of course Horace at the piano. This one he calls Sweet Sweetie Dee. Curly Russell bass and Max Roach the drummer. It's Parisian Thoroughfare. People who are well acquainted with Ellingtonia usually get around to doing this one. This is the original recording of Duke and the orchestra with some wonderful Ben Webster tenor and Lawrence Brown trombone. All Too Soon. Tenor chorus, and then the pep section playing the little riff behind it. That's what Duke called that particular section of the band, the pep section. Just ideal background for that beautiful ballad. All Too Soon, Duke Ellington and the Orchestra from 1940. Here's Pee Wee Russell on a side recorded for the Hot Club Record Society, reissued on Riverside. Features Max Kaminsky trumpet, Dickie Wells trombone, Al Gold tenor saxophone. They must have had somebody else on call because Al Gold was strictly a session man. James P. Johnson is the pianist, the daddy of almost all of the jazz pianists from the East Coast. Freddie Green guitar, and this album, by the way, this record, one of those rarities of a solo by Freddie Green. Mark this one down. It only happens a few times in his long career with Basie. This is not with Basie. Wellman Broad is the bassist, Zooty Singleton the drummer, and Dinah. And that was Dinah, done for you by Pee Wee Russell and the All-Stars. Max Kaminsky was the trumpet, Dickie Wells trombone. Strange, disparate musicians here. Dickie Wells trombone, Pee Wee Russell clarinet, Al Gold tenor saxophone, James P. Johnson piano, Freddie Green guitar, and Wellman Broad the bassist, and Zooty Singleton the drummer. Let's listen to Louis Armstrong. This is Louis with the All-Stars. He was in California, and this particular side was recorded at the Crescendo, January 21st of 1955. Louis and the All-Stars and strutting with some barbecue.
We're going to keep it rolling for you this set. Jumping into the fiddle song called Strutting with Some Barbecue.
Thank you.
Yeah, that was Louis Armstrong and the All-Stars from the California Concerts album. That was at California Concert Hall. All right. Let's listen now to Jess Stacy, one of my early heroes. Jess with a rhythm section here, and this is Fascinating Rhythm. Jess Stacy at the piano. Fascinating Rhythm, one of the Gershwin favorites. Well, let's get up and march around the dinner table again. This, we can make it one more time. Bob Crosby in the orchestra and another one of those great Sousa marches, El Capitan.
Thank you.
Yeah, that was the Bobcats again, marching around here. El Capitan, another one of those famous Sousa marches. I hear a lot of, when I'm home and I don't want to take time to pick out a record to play for my own amazement, I turn on the cable channel that gives me the big band sounds, big bands and some of the, well, they don't call it jazz, but they get pretty close to it sometimes. And they play a lot of Django Reinhardt. I'd say two or three times an afternoon, hear something by Django. And I decide if he's that popular, maybe I ought to play some too. This one is called Paris 1945, Django Reinhardt and the